Former President Trump now has a blog after being banned from most social media outlets. But so far, it's failing to really gain traction online. NBC News senior reporter Brandi Zadronsky joins us now. Brandi, can you break down the numbers for us? I mean, what does engagement with Trump's blog look like right now?
Hey there. Yeah, so we are a week out from Trump's unveiling his new big blog. And it's attracted, the data shows, just over 212,000 engagements. Now, engagements means backlinks, it means social interactions. So these are like likes, shares, comments, all the stuff that you do across Facebook, Twitter, Pinterest, and even Reddit. Now, 212,000, it might sound like a big number, but that's an actually incredibly small number. You know, before the ban, a single Trump tweet was typically liked and retweeted hundreds of thousands, if not millions of times. So the numbers here are really, really not great. The top post, in fact, Trump responded to the Facebook Oversight Board's decision to uphold his ban. This is the very top blog post of Trump. It garnered only 16,000 engagements.
So Brandi, give us the big picture here. I mean, what does this really say about the power that social media companies have in removing someone from their platforms?
Well, it says that deplatforming, which means cutting off a user from their followers, is very effective. And it doesn't just boot and reduce harmful speech on a particular platform. It also restricts someone's ability to attract a similar audience on an alternative platform. There's really a limited body of academic research. And what it suggests is that deplatforming can clean up a platform, it can reduce the size of extremist communities, but it also says that there are unintended consequences, right? Because when a community migrates to their own sort of self-hosted platform, that can be a dangerous thing. But this isn't even happening in Trump's case. Jeremy Blackburn, an academic researcher who studies deplatforming, he told me, quote, it's so technologically primitive that there's no way for his followers to even migrate.
So if it's that primitive, Brandi, I mean, is there any sense of what this low engagement could mean for Trump's possible reelection effort?
This is not going to be the way that he amplifies any messages to would-be future voters. Trump needs to be back on Facebook if he's going to be a viable candidate for 2024. His team still contends that they're going to build their own social media platform. That's very hard technically to do. And if his blog is any indication, people might not just be as excited to hear what he has to say. His fundraising, online political strategy, they both depend on Facebook. He spent $160 million on Facebook ads in last year's election. And Facebook has 6 months to decide whether he's allowed back on. So he needs that platform back and badly.